We are back now with a look at sports. After sitting on the sidelines for the past 2 weeks, the CSUB women's basketball team took to the court in Las Vegas to compete for the Big West title. 17 Sports Director Taylor Schaub was at the Mandalay Bay Resort all day following Cal State and joins us now with a recap of the Roadrunners' performance. Taylor?
Tammy, being here in Las Vegas, I can't help but think about the last time that CSUB was in Sin City. That, of course, was when they were still a part of the Western Athletic Conference, taking part in the WAC tournament right before COVID shut down pretty much all of collegiate sports, professional sports, and obviously youth sports in Kern County. Well, if you fast forward a year, today they are back. They're playing in the Big West tournament, their first year in the Big West, and they took on Hawaii for the chance to make it to the next round. The CSUB Roadrunners hit the hardwood Wednesday afternoon looking to simply survive in advance. The women's team had been on a roll before another COVID outbreak halted the runners right in their tracks. Despite the long layoff, Coach Greg McCall's girls looked good early on. Andy Easley led a fierce offensive attack, going 4-for-4 from beyond the arc. But the rust started to show for the Roadrunners just before halftime. Hawaii took the lead heading into the locker room and never really looked back. Led by Jaden Alexander in her sweet three-point stroke, Hawaii outscored CSUB 64-46 over the final three quarters, winning 81-67 to advance to the semifinals on Friday. Coach Greg McCall spoke post-game about the damaging effects this past quarantine period had on his team.
That does play a huge factor when you're not able to work out. You know, you're not able to get into the gym and not touch a ball for 14 days. That's tough. That's tough for anybody. Any athlete that stays out from the game, it's just going to take a while for them to get back. We were in a good rhythm and a good place mentally for us to be able to win this game. But then, of course, COVID.
Post-game, there was one silver lining for the runners. Graduate transfer Andy Easley announced that she will rejoin the team for one final season.
I'm going to come back and play one more year, so I'm excited for that. I'm excited to play with these teammates one more time and play with these coaches. I couldn't ask for a better situation to be in. So that is a silver lining that next year every single person will be back and we have a big chip on our shoulder.
And a reminder, Tammy, that the men's team will play tomorrow at 2 p.m. They are taking on UC Davis, a team that they have not faced all year. In Las Vegas, Taylor Schaub, 17 News.